Ibran, we are from the University Teknologi Mara, Cawangan Sarawak, Kampus Samarahan. So today we want to present about the hibiscus stem cutting. Most people call it is a bunga raya, bunga kebangsaan. So first thing first about the introduction of group member. Firstly, Ikwan Syamil bin Abdullah. Secondly, Mawla Taufik bin Jamaluddin, Kelvin Ngelambong, anak Vincent Ugai, and
Hi everyone, today I would like to introduce to you our national flower, Hibiscus rosa sinensis. The specific alphabet rosa sinensis literally means rose of China, though it is not closely related to the two roses. On 28 July 1960, Tunku Abdul Rahman Putra Al-Haj declared Hibiscus bunga raya as the national flower. The word bunga raya in Malay means flower, while raya in Malay means celebratory or grand. The hibiscus rosa sinensis is literally known as the celebratory flower in Malay. Hibiscus is one of the most favorite flowers by the gardener because of the uniqueness of the flower. The characteristics of the hibiscus are leaves are lobes and may be smooth or be covered by the plant hair. Hibiscus come out with various types of color and sizes. The petal of flower is varied from disc shape petals to show the double flowers. The color is solid, where the center of the contrasting the side color. Besides, flower is easy to take care of. Not only that, hibiscus came out with various types, which is copperial alba, double flower pink, single flower yellow with pink venation, and a lot more. Now, let us show you how to plant it up by yourself step by step.
Alright, for the benefit of hibiscus, firstly, it can use for landscape. The mostly people use it for their landscape, for example, at outside home, office, and garden. This is to make the cheerful the atmosphere and beautiful the scenery. So next about the people can use it to produce perfume product. This is the natural fragrance of flower can provide therapeutic and aromatherapy effect. It also free from the chemical. For the third is a treatment. It can use for treatment or medicine for human health based on method traditional or modern. For example, this is can help the for low blood pressure, low fat level, promote weight loss, boost the immune system, and hair treatment.
Hello, my name is Resti Joseph. So today I'm going to present about the tools and materials that can be used to conduct the stem cutting for hibiscus plant. So the first one is sketches. Sketches is used to cut the hibiscus stem and leaves. And number two is root hormone powder. So root hormone powder is used to help the plant to develop its roots more quickly. And number three is plastic pot. Plastic pot is used as a place to put the soil in it. Next one is soil. So soil is used as a medium to plant the hibiscus. And the last is the hibiscus plant. So this hibiscus plant is used to conduct the stem cutting.
Hello, my name is Ikwan Syamil bin Abdullah. Today I will teach you how to do stem cutting of hibiscus, or we call bunga raya, using the root hormone powder. Let's go.
Okay, as you can see, this is our material just explained by my friend Erdi. So this is the flower pot with the soil, water, the root hormone powder, sketcher, and the stem of the hibiscus, or we call it bunga raya. First, we must take the stem of bunga raya with the long 6 or 8 cm, 8 inches, 6 or 8 inches. So this is the 8 inch of the stem, and we cut it just like this. Okay. So after that, we remove the leaf and leave the one or two leaf at the stem, and after that we wet the stem with the long 3 inches to the water. We select this. After that, we put the part of the stem that get wet to the hormone powder. Just doing like this. That make the hole into the soil with the deep 3 inches using our finger. This and put the stem into the hole and close it. Make sure all the part of the stem that get root powder cover it with the soil. Okay, just like that.
Okay, next, after that, we watering the plant morning and evening for every day, and put the plant in the bright area. Then you can put the plant under the direct sunlight after 10 and for next 10 or 15 days.
So next, I'm going to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of stem cutting for hibiscus. So the advantages number one is hibiscus is popular for its potential to reduce high blood pressure. Modern studies shows a promise for both the tea and hibiscus plant extract to lower the blood pressure and cholesterol levels. And advantages number two is hibiscus is known as a decorative plant. And advantages number three is hibiscus also known as a popular herbal remedy in countries throughout the world. While in disadvantages, first one is about problematic pace. So hibiscus are not typically pledged by many insects, but spider mites, snake beetles, white flies, and aphids can occasionally become a problem to a hibiscus. Disadvantages number two is about temperamental, about temperature. Despite their reputation as relatively known as a low maintenance plants, the tropical hibiscus did not like a sudden changes in air temperature or soil moisture, or to be caught in a trap.
Okay, this is the expenses of tools and materials. All these of tools and material you can get at the Shopee, or you can get at the shop that sell tools and material of agriculture. First, we have the sketcher with the price RM 5.50. Next, we have the root hormone powder with the price RM 6.30. Next, we have the flower pot with different size and different price, with the price start with RM 0.25 to RM 1.05. So you can choose the regular size of the flower pot for your stem cutting. Next, we have the stem hibiscus with the price RM 12 for 10 stem hibiscus, or we call bunga raya. And the last one, we have the soil or black soil with the price RM 1.20 for 1 kg of soil. The stem and the soil you can get free. For the stem, you can get from your neighbor or your friend. And for the soil, you can use the ordinary soil. Okay, this is the example price of hibiscus and market. So I get this example of the market at the Shopee. So the market sell 4 different color of the flower hibiscus, which is white, red, pink and yellow. For the price of white color, we have RM 11.31 cent ringgit. For the pink color, we have RM 13.21 cent ringgit, and for the red, we have RM 11.31 cent ringgit. The price of the yellow we cannot see because it out of the stock. And for the tall of the plant, from the bottom of polybag to the top of the plant, we have 36 cm of the hibiscus plant. So if you want to buy some of hibiscus, you can search at Shopee, Lazada, Facebook page or near of your home. Okay, I want to tell you the interesting part of making stem cutting by ourselves. First, we can save our money. We don't need to have buy a hibiscus or bunga raya at the Shopee. We only have to buy the tools and material, and from that we can generate a lot of hibiscus just by using a little bit of our money. Also, we can generate income. For example, the stem cutting that we do, we can sell it to the Shopee, Lazada and Facebook. And from that, we can generate income from the stem cutting of hibiscus that we do. And as you can see, not only the stem cutting that we can do, at the same time, we can do the marketing from the stem cutting that we do.
In conclusion, hibiscus is very easy to plant with stem cutting, where you only need a few steps to finish the planting process. We do not use a lot of material to do the stem cutting. Not only that, the success rate of hibiscus to grow and live using the stem cutting is very high. Planting a hibiscus also has a lot of benefit, just like what my friend explained just now. So that is all from us. I hope you like the video and learn from it. Thank you. Bye.